Welcome to RyGurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about field types in ServiceNow. So if you're new to this channel and not yet subscribed to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. We'll discuss here what is field types, and how we can use it, different field types in real life example. So the fields are the individual piece of data in a records are called fields. Users enter data in fields on the form or by using the list editor. Administrators can create new fields or modify existing fields. User can enter data in fields by using the list editor or by using a form. In form view, fields appear as a field in the form, and in list view, they appear as a columns of data in the table. Administrator can create any number of new fields or change the type of existing fields. When we are using fields, we have to simply navigate to any form editor. So here I'm opening problem statement. And when we are jumping to the problems, you'll find it out open section here where you'll get the list of problems are available. So if I want to create a new fields, I will simply go to the create new field. So right now I'm not covering creation of new field. I've already covered in separate video. So if you want, I will include the URL in my description tab so you can easily access it. Here we'll discuss about different field types which is available in ServiceNow. So simply go to this sections and right click on the menu tab and click on configure form design. When you will click on configure form design, you will find it all the fields which is already existing in ServiceNow is available in left section. Some of them are already used in problems. Now we are focusing on field types. So field types audio is the first field type in ServiceNow. You can find it out. Various field types are available in ServiceNow. So audio field types for uploading and embedding .mp3 or .ogg audio files. Second is choice. Choice is list of configurable choices. Calendar date and time is basically used for the type of calendar date and time. Whenever it is required, we can use it. Then collections. Collections are a very big component in ServiceNow and which is majorly used in ServiceNow. Dictionary entries with the collections type represent the table rather than a field or on the table. Changes such as attributes or the read-only checkboxes applied to this entry are applied to the table. Rather than pre-specified fields, the entry automatically create when a table is created. There should not be more than one entry for a table of this type. You can find it out currency, which where we have to define the currency. You will also find it out different other sections like color, conditioning, string, conditional string. If I want to take out any of the fields from here, I will simply drag and drop it to here, and this new fields will be added here. We have to specify the type of the fields and enter the detail, and from there onwards we can use it. Once we are done, we have to save the file, or we have to save this form, and this field will be permanently added into problem form. Now, conditions are basically used for the field that add to the condition builder to a form. We must specify a dependent field that references the table name. Currencies are basically used for the different locations currency. And we can also include dollar, euros, these type of parameters we can include it. Data structures, we have string. String comes under data structure, then boolean, integer, decimal, object and array. These six components will appear inside the data structure where we can utilize these types and use it for further. You can see it here as well, string. Here, list are here, and the array and objects are available on top. Next is decimal. So number with up to two digits after the decimal points are allowed in the decimal sections. When we are talking about the document ID, we have to provide the document ID in record for our reference. Domain ID is basically system field that contains a reference to the domain. Due date is basically a string input field that stores the date and time. Duration is basically length of time stored in the database as an integer, number of milliseconds, but appears in days, hours, minutes, and seconds. Encrypted text is also available in this field type. So if we want to jump to the encrypted text, we have to store our encrypted information for the security reason, depending on the user's encryption context. The fields may be hidden, the value may be hidden, or the field and the value may display. Then the field name reference field or field name in the table selected in table name field type, make this field dependent on the table name field. File attachment is also, we can use it. Fields for holding a file or fields holds one file, all the types are supported. You can not find some of the fields which is not available here because we have opened problem forms. When we are searching on the global form, we will find it that all these options which I mentioned here is available here. We can also use HTML types, that is string field with a built-in HTML editor. Icon is also available. Icon is a type of field. So for the icon field, we can use a string field that provides the user access to an icon picker in a form. By default, the favorite icon set is used. Image, if I want to upload any specific type of image, I will mark this image into a field type image. Fields for uploading the embedding image. IP address, we can also use IP address for variable character fields as stored IP version 4 and IP version 6 addresses. Journal is basically a field type that accepts text entries and displays previous entries with a username and timestamp. General input is again a new field type which accepts text entries but does not allow or displays previous entries. Journal list is basically a field that displays the contents of journal fields. We must specify the journal field as a dependent field. If a journal list field depends on more than one journal field, the entries are displayed chronologically. List are the reference field that accept multiple references rather than just once. Long field type is basically integer field types that contains a longer number than the integer field. For the encryption point of view and the security reason, password is a one encrypted field. Password one is one-way encrypted text field that stored passwords with one-way encryption. One-way encryption stores the password as a secure hash value that cannot be decrypted. Password 2 is basically two-way encrypted text field that stores password with two-way encryption. Two-way encryption stores the password as a secure encrypted value that can be decrypted programmatically within the instance. We can use password 2 encryption with form variable to encrypt the fields on form. Percent complete is basically used for the decimal field that renders a percent complete bar in list. We can convert any existing decimal fields to a percent complete field. Phone number is basically E164 string field that provides E164 compliant formatting and validation for telephone number. Price is basically stored for the field that enables control over conversions and display. Script is another important thing, text field that accepts JavaScript code input and provides controls such as syntax checking and formatting. It also provides a list of fields and server APIs. We must specify the dependent field that references the table name of the list of the fields. Script plain is basically a text field that accepts JavaScript code input and provides controls such as syntax checking and formatting. So these are the type of field. There are various type of fields is available or field type is available in ServiceNow. I've covered many of them, but still there are a lot more in terms of field types in ServiceNow. If you have enjoyed the session and really like the content of this video, kindly share within your circle and don't forget to like and subscribe the channel for the further update. Thank you for watching.